Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom.
Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. And if you follow Pioneer right now, you know that the format is overrun with combo decks. Inverter combos, Heliod combos, Lotus Breach combos. Well, our deck today, a Pioneer take on 8 rack, is basically like whatever. Opponent, play your combo deck. I'm just going to play infinite discarded Thought Seizes and make you discard your combo pieces before you get a chance to resolve them. So this one comes to us from Knight Armory, who took it to a top 32 finish in a recent Pioneer Challenge, I believe, on Magic Online. So congrats to Knight Armory on a really sweet deck. And a quick reminder before we break down 8 rack for Pioneer. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it made a video, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So Pioneer 8 rack, if you're wondering where the name comes from, maybe you're a newer player, well, it refers to a card that actually isn't in Pioneer. From the earliest days of Magic, the rack. So the rack is this one mana artifact that basically punishes you for not having many cards in your hand, dealing damage to you each turn on your upkeep. So the idea of Pioneer 8 rack is to kind of recreate the rack effect using Shrieking Affliction, racks 1 through 4, and then Davriel Rogue Shadow Mage, racks 5, 6, 7, 8. So we still have 8 racks in the format. Shrieking Affliction, if our opponent has one or less cards in hand on their upkeep, they lose 3 life. Davriel, only 2 damage if our opponent has one or less cards in hand, but it also is a discard spell in and of itself, which gives us some upside. So the hope of our deck is we are going to stack up at least 1, maybe 2 or 3 of these effects on the battlefield, and then spend the rest of the game trying to empty our opponent's hand, so they're slowly going to get drained out by our Davriels and our Shrieking Afflictions. We also have another discard payoff in Waste Not. So Waste Not, it's kind of weird. This is the fairest way you can possibly play Waste Not. We've played it before in like Storm style decks where you're trying to get your opponent to like draw and discard a ton of cards and do a ton of things. In this deck, we're playing Waste Not really fairly. With Waste Not on the battlefield, when our opponent discards a creature, we make a 2-2 zombie. When they discard a land, we get 2 mana. And when they discard a non-creature non-land, we get to draw a card. So in our deck, we're basically playing Waste Not and then Thought Seizing our opponent or activating Davriel. So we'll get a zombie here, draw a card there, little bits of incremental value, but still another payoff for making our opponent discard cards. So these are the main payoffs in our deck. How are we making our opponent discard? We start off at 1 mana. Thought Seize, you know what it does. Basically every deck in Pioneer plays it. Just choose a card from our opponent's hand, make them discard it, can't be a land, we lose 2 life. Vicious Rumors is a little more unique though. 1 mana, it deals a damage to each opponent. Each opponent discards a card and mills a card from the top of their library, and we get to gain a life. So we don't have any control over Vicious Rumors, but this is still a way to just get a card out of our opponent's hand, maybe trigger our Waste Not to get a zombie or draw a card or whatever for just 1 mana. Then we have Unburden. Unburden, a little bit weird. It's basically a mind rot. Opponent discards 2 cards for 3 mana. The upside of Unburden is we can always cycle it away if it's bad. So if we already have our opponent empty-handed and discard is a dead draw off the top of our deck, we can cycle it away, draw a new card, maybe something a little bit more relevant. Then we have a couple of creature-based discard effects. Bugler Rats just makes our opponent discard a card when it comes into play. Rankled Master of Pranks, when it hits our opponent, can force our opponent to discard and do a whole bunch of other things. So keeping the discard going, plus cards like Rankle help us speed up our clock to close out the game. We can't always rely on 3 damage a turn from Shrieking Affliction over the course of like 8 turns to win the game or whatever. So Rankle Bugler Rats help speed that up a little bit. Speaking of speeding up the clock, our best way to just close out the game really quickly once our opponent's empty-handed is 2 copies of Reality Smasher. Just a 5-5 trample haster that's hard to kill because our opponent's got to discard a card if they want to target it, and it's going to be hard for our opponent to discard a card because we're going to have them empty-handed. So Reality Smasher comes down, smashes our opponent's life total, closes out the game really quickly. Otherwise, we get some Fatal Pushes, Murderous Riders for removal, Mana Base, we actually get a lot of sweet utility lands. Castle Lockwain for card draw, Mutavault, nice threat in the Mana Base. Ifnir Deadlands, Cave of Coilos probably look weird, but remember, our Reality Smasher needs actual colorless mana, so these are kind of actually dual lands. Like, Ifnir Deadlands is a black colorless dual land when it comes to our Reality Smasher. Otherwise, Urborg turns our colorless lands into black sources if we need more black mana. A bunch
bunch of basic swamps. In the sideboard, we get a whole slew of removal spells, Legion's End, Collective Brutality for aggro, Noxious Grass for green things, Bantu's Last Reckoning as a painful but cheap wrath, making us skip a turn essentially by not untapping. Liliana the Last Hope can be good against X1s, where we're just sniping Elvish Mystics, other small creatures, plus it can grind out value, getting things back from the graveyard, and in control matchups, rush towards ultimate to win the game. Otherwise, Damping Sphere for the Lotus Breach tile of combo deck, Leyline of the Void to slow down graveyard decks, and that is Pioneer 8 Rack. And that's been our instant deck for today. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon. If you enjoyed today's deck, make sure to purchase it from our sponsor, Card Kingdom. For a limited time, you can get a Scoop Soldier sticker for free if you mention Scoop Soldier in your order notes during checkout. Thanks for watching the video! If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.